Can you use spray foam insulation to help transform your Michigan basement? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to discuss how spray foam can help you transform that Michigan basement. Now before we get into this too much, please go below and make that thumbs up button blue. Thank you. Did you do it? Thanks. So, how does this work, transforming that Michigan basement? So the first thing you should do is waterproof. Now, if you're looking at a Michigan basement, you're looking at most likely stone walls, so you want to waterproof those walls. Now, there's a bunch of different options for that, whether it's some type of sealant base that you're going to coat the walls with or actually put up a structure against the walls. Whatever your route is, you want to make sure that it's good and waterproof. Now, the next thing you want to do is make sure you put a vapor barrier on the floor because, again, it's usually going to be dirt. We usually recommend 6mm plastic as a minimum. Again, depending on how luxurious you want this basement to be, will determine if you're going to just put plastic down, if you're going to put a poured floor, whatever the case, you'll make that decision for your project. Now, here is where the magic of spray foam comes into play. Here's where you would spray the walls and the rim joist. It's really important to make sure you do not miss that rim joist and possibly the ceiling of the basement or the floor of the house, depending on, again, what you're going to be using that room for. But this is where spray foam comes in. It's that last step to make sure that all the air seal is established on the outside walls and that rim joist. I can't stress this enough. When you're looking at insulating and air sealing, that rim joist is going to be the cornerstone of this project. You want to make sure that you spray foam that area specifically so that you get that air seal. If you do not use spray foam and you leave that area just open to air penetrations, you're going to see a lot of issues, potentially moisture issues specifically when you're looking at a Michigan basement that has a lot of penetrations and gaps. So these are just a few quick steps, again, a broad overview of how you can transform your Michigan basement and how you can use spray foam to put the final touches on. If you want to learn more about Michigan basements in relation to insulation, please check out the link below. Don't forget to like this video, always subscribe to our channel, and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.